Yes, a very good morning to all of you. 10th B, yesterday I put one message in the group, which was about robotics workshop. Na? Only two students have willingly given me their name. What about the rest? मतलब आपको इतना ज्यादा मैंने बूस्ट कर दिया, सब कुछ लिखा ग्रुप में दैट इट इज गोइंग टू बी बेनिफिशियल फॉर यू. यू लीस्ट बॉदर, जस्ट गो थ्रू दैट दैट सर्कुलर केयरफुली एंड लेट मी गिव मी योर नेम सो दैट आई कैन फॉरवर्ड योर नेम इन टू एक्टिविटी डिपार्टमेंट. राइट, ओनली टू स्टूडेंट्स टिल नाउ हैव गिवन मी द नेम. चलिए, सो वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 5th, दैट इज एपी 5.1 we have started. Exercise 5.1 we have started. Exercise 5.1, first question was going on. First question, second part we are going to start with. Question first, second part. So 10th C have joined, so let me tell them that till now we just have done the definition of AP and what are the things which are used in the first exercise that we have discussed, that AP is a series, it is a type of series in which the succeeding term is obtained by adding a fixed number in the preceding term. That is that and so on, right? We have done the definition of AP and then I have told you people that in AP first exercise you have to remember that first term it is denoted by A, common difference is denoted by D. First term is A, common difference is D, right? And from these two, what is the general form of the AP? General form of the AP is A first term, adding the common difference, second term A plus D, adding again the common difference to this, this is A plus 2B, adding again the common difference to it, it is A plus 3D and so on. This is the general form of the AP which we have discussed on Saturday. Right, so how to denote the different kind of terms and different kind of, you can say, abbreviation for AP? First term is denoted by A1, second term A2, third term A3 and fourth term A4 and so on, right? So how to find is what we will see in the first exercise, that common difference is obtained if you do the difference of any two consecutive terms. It doesn't mean that if you do the difference of these two only then you will get the common difference. No, you take any two consecutive terms. Consecutive means if you are taking second, then take the third one to take the difference. 9 minus 3, 6. If you're taking third, take the fourth one. 12 minus 9, 3, like this, right? So having this information in mind, I just have repeated because the other class has also joined. They are to know these things. Otherwise, we have done it, right? So 5.1, first question, first part have been done. Let us start with the second part. But the question is, let me read the heading of the question. In which of the following situation does the list of the numbers involved in the given progression is AP and why? So we have to see, I told you that there are so many examples from our daily life also, which involves the concept of AP, right? So there are certain real life examples which we have to explain that whether they are forming AP or not, right? So second part I'm going to start with. The amount of air present in a cylinder when a vacuum pump removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder at a time. So first of all, we'll make the series. We will list out the number out of this situation. So let us, he says 1/4 of the remaining in the cylinder at a time. Amount of air. If we see that amount of air in the cylinder, then what it represent? Amount of air in the cylinder represent the volume of the cylinder. So let us suppose that in starting, amount of air is equal to V. Starting में हम कह देते हैं कि total amount of air जो cylinder में है that is V, right? Vacuum pump removes 1/4 of the air remaining in the cylinder. First part में जितना भी volume है vacuum pump से जब हमने air को pump out किया तो how much air have been pumped out from the cylinder? 1/4. So initially the air represent in the cylinder is you are having V, right? So air removed is equal to 1/4 of V, that is V/4. ठीक है? First time, यहाँ पे first time लिख लो. First time the air removed is this. Second time air removed. Air removed is 1/4 of the remaining. 1/4 of the remaining का क्या मतलब है? जो भी आपके पास remaining बचेगा, इतना remove हो गया, पहले तो remaining निकालो, second time बाद में. So remaining air is equal to V minus V/4. This was initial. This have been removed. So remaining is equal to 3V/4. Right? So second time air removed one by fourth of the remaining air, jitni air usme bachi hai uska 1/4. So this is 1/4 of 3V/4, that means 3V/16, right? So second time air removed is equal to this. Therefore, air left is equal to 3V/4 minus 3V/16. When you do that, take the LCM, this is 12V minus 9V, and that is equal to minus 3V, that is equal to 9V/16. So this much air is left in when we are looking at the second time. So first time the remaining air is 3V/4. Let us take it to be A1, the first term of the AP. Second time the air left is 9V/16. Let us take it to be A2, right? Every time 1/4 of the remaining air have been removed and some air is left. Whatever air is left, that is to be counted, right? So remaining air is to be counted. So that's why I'm taking it to be the second term of the AP, right? So let us see that the third time air removed is equal to 1/4 of 9V/16, that is 9V/64. So third time the air left is equal to जो भी हमारे पास starting में air थी, that means 9Y/16, उसमें से removed air is to be minus 64 is the LCM. This is 36V minus 9V. This is 27V/64. So this is A3, third term of AP. Three terms are sufficient to tell whether the given series forms an AP or no. So we are getting A1 is equal to 3V/4. A2 is equal to 9V/16. And A3 is equal to 27V/64, and so on. In this way, you will get the terms of, I should not say AP, you get certain terms. When we say that these terms are forming AP, if the difference between two consecutive terms remains the same. Let us find the difference between first two. 9V/16 minus 3V/4. 16 is the LCM. This is 9V. 12V, this becomes 3V/16, right?
सो आप लिखो ए टू माइनस ए वन इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग डी. नाउ राइट ए थ्री माइनस ए टू. 27v over 64 minus 9v over 16. LCM. So this will be 97v minus 36v. So what this becomes? Minus 9v over 64. After obtaining the term, we see the difference between two consecutive terms, that means a2 minus a1 and a3 minus a2, they are not coming out to be same. Same nahi aa raha. So iska matlab kya hua? In the last, what you will say that here, the difference between two consecutive terms is not the same. Therefore, given situation doesn't form AP. So how you will conclude that here the difference between two consecutive terms is not the same. Therefore, the given situation doesn't form an AP. Given situations ki hamare paas AP jo hai wo nahi ban sakti as difference between two consecutive terms is not same. What is the definition of AP? Difference between two consecutive terms, it should remain the same. If the difference is not the same, we'll say that the given situation is not an AP. Let us do the fourth part.
Third part आप खुद करोगे, fourth मैं करवाने लगी हूँ.
Fourth part is amount of money in the account every year when rupees 1000 is deposited at compound interest at rupees at 8% per annum.
क्या है हमारे पास P दिया हुआ है 1000
and you are given
rather 10,000
R, that is rate of interest 8%, right? Every year means 1 year, second year, third year and so on. So we need to find the series of, you can say, the list of the rupees of amount in the different year.
So let us take amount in the first year A1. Kya formula hota hai amount ka? P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to power T.
This we have done, right?
So P is 10,000 into 1 plus 8 by 100, T is 1. Kyunki first year ke liye count kar rahe hain. Amount A1 is amount that is in the first year. So this will be 108 over 100 raised to power 1. So you will be having 10,000 into 108 over 100. Two zeros get cancelled, 10800 rupees. This is the amount in the first year. This is the amount in the first year. So let us see what is the amount in the second year. Let us denote it as A2. P into 1 plus R by 100 raised to power 2. This time the power will be 2. So you will be having, this is 10,000 into 1 plus R by 100 raised to power 2. So this is 10,000 into 108 by 100 raised to power 2. When you will solve it, you will get it to be 12,597. Just a minute, wait. You will take the value of P to be 10,800 instead of 10,000. Starting wali P ki value nahi leni aapne. Previous year ka jo amount hai, wo is year mein principal ki tarah count hoga. Jab aap isko solve karoge, you will get 12,597. सॉल्व में आपके लिए छोड़ रही हूँ, ठीक है? देन अमाउंट इन द थर्ड ईयर पी इनटू 1 प्लस आर बाय 100 रेस टू पावर 3. नाउ दिस पी विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय अमाउंट ऑफ द प्रीवियस ईयर
अमाउंट विल बिकम प्रिंसिपल इन द रीसेंट ईयर.
सो दिस विल बी 12,597 इनटू 1 प्लस आर इज 8 बाय 100 रेस टू पावर 3.
व्हेन यू विल सॉल्व इट, यू विल गेट इट टू बी 15,869. Three terms are more than sufficient to see whether the given situation is forming AP or not. So let me list out the terms.
We are having A1, 10,800, A2, 12,597, A3, 15,869, and so on.
So let us find the difference between the two consecutive terms. So if we see the difference between two consecutive terms, a2 minus a1, 12597 minus 10,800. So this will be 1797 is the difference between these two. ठीक है, चलिए let us find the difference between a3 minus a2. This is 15869 minus 12597. 12597. This is 2. This is 7. This is 2. This is 1. Now you see, when I find the difference between the first two term, I get 1797. And when I get the difference between the third and the second, I get 1272. In the last, what you will write? As difference between, as difference between two consecutive terms is not the same, therefore given situation doesn't form AP. अगर दो कंसेक्टिव टर्म्स के बीच में डिफरेंस सेम नहीं आ रहा, देन द गिवन प्रोग्रेस गिवन यू कैन से लिस्ट ऑफ टर्म्स दे कांट बी रिगार्डेड एज द टर्म्स ऑफ एपी. सो द गिवन सिचुएशन डजंट लीड टू एन एपी. राइट, लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेकंड क्वेश्चन. क्वेश्चन नंबर सेकंड. Second question is, write first four terms of AP whose first term and common difference is given. First of all, I will do fourth part. फर्स्ट टर्म इज माइनस वन एंड कॉमन डिफरेंस इज 1/2. हमने फर्स्ट फोर टर्म्स एपी की लिखनी है. हाँ जी अमृतपाल, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से?
मैं आपने जो लास्ट पार्ट था उसमें आपने सम हमेशा चेंज किया ना 800 प्लस किया, उसमें सब में 10,000 ही आना था.
क्यों 10,000 क्यों आएगा? कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट है, इट्स नॉट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट में पिछले साल का अमाउंट नेक्स्ट ईयर का प्रिंसिपल बनता है. This is not simple interest. चलिए, so यहाँ पे हमारे पास a दिया हुआ है minus one and d is given to be 1/2. D is given to be 1/2. हमने terms find करनी है. तो first term a it is given to be minus one. Second term a two. Formula क्या होता है? यहाँ पे two है. तो a प्लस 1d, दैट मीन्स माइनस 1 प्लस 1/2, दैट इज माइनस 2 प्लस 1/2, दैट इज माइनस 1/2. दिस इज द सेकंड टर्म ऑफ द एपी. थर्ड टर्म a3, इफ हियर इट इज 3, इट विल बी रिटन a प्लस 2d. वेरी इजी टू राइट द फॉर्मूला. 2 है तो 1d, 3 है तो 2d. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू माइनस 1 प्लस 2 इनटू d, दैट इज 1/2. This 2 and 2 get cancelled. Minus 1 plus 1, that is equal to 0. This is the third term of the AP. Fourth term, A4. This is A plus 3D. Here it is 4. So we will write here 3D. Right? Jitni term hoti hai, usse kam D ke saath lag jata hai. So this is equal to minus 1 plus 3 into D. Value of D is 1/2. So this is minus 2 plus 3/2. And this is equal to 1/2. These are the first four terms of the given AP. By using the formula A for the first term, A plus D for the second term, A plus 2D for the third term, A plus 3D for the fourth term, you are getting the first four terms of AP. Rest of the part will be your homework. Ek ek party karwaungi sab mein se. Question number third. Third question is, for the following APs, write the first term and the common difference. I am doing fourth part. 0.6 1.7, 2.8, 3.9. Given AP is this. This time AP is given to us. We are to write the first term and the common difference. Very easily, very sure that first term is 0.6, right? So now you need to write the common difference. That means D. How to write the common difference? Common difference is the difference of two consecutive terms. So I should write A2 minus A1. That is 1.6 minus 0.6. This is equal to 1.1. This is a common difference. What is common difference? Difference between any two consecutive terms. You can write A2 minus A1. You can write A3 minus A2. You can write A4 minus A3 and so on. Right? Rest of the parts you'll do yourself. Question number 4. Which of the following are AP? If they are an AP, find their common difference and write three more terms. So first of all, I will do second part. The terms are like this. First of all, we have to check whether this series, this list of terms, it is forming an AP or not. For that, what to do? Hame first difference, common difference between the two consecutive terms nikalna. So we can get here A2 minus A1. This is 5 by 2 minus 2. This is 5 minus 4 by 2. And this is 1 by 2. Right? Difference between two consecutive terms. Then A3 minus A2. That is 3 minus 5 by 2. That is 6 minus 5 by 2. That is 1 by 2. Okay? A3 minus A2. Now, let us find A4 minus A3. This is 7 by 2 minus 3. This is 7 by 6 by 2 and this is 1 by 2. Whatever terms are given to us for all those, if we are finding, ab iske liye sabke liye aapko nikalna padega. Ye nahi aapne pehle do ka nikal ke bol diya. Whatever terms are listed up here, we have to find the difference between all the consecutive terms. That means A2 minus A1, A3 minus A2 and A4 minus A3. And what we are observing that the difference remains the same. आप लिखोगे as the difference between two consecutive terms remains the same, therefore the given list form an AP. Given list हमारे पास AP होगी. And he says if it is AP, then find the next term. If I ask you what is the common difference of this AP, what you will say? In APs का common difference क्या है? Anyone? Amritpal or Krishan? Anyone else? Amrit Par, Krishan. More student I need to give the answer. Vanshika is again absent. More student should give the answer. Hanji, raise your hand. Akhilesh, what is the common difference of this AP? Akhilesh. Akhilesh, what is the common difference of this AP? Hanji Laksh, you tell.
One by two
is the common difference of this AP. जो भी दो consecutive terms का difference होता है उसी को हम common difference बोलते हैं. So common difference of this given list यानी कि given AP is 1/2. So we have to write the next terms, next four terms. Let us write the next four terms. पहले देख लो हमें कौन कौन सी term दी हुई है. 1, 2, 3, 4. A4 तक दिया हुआ है. So you will find A5. This is A plus 4D. That is 2 plus 4 into 1 by 2, that is 2 plus 2, that is 4. Okay? So A6, that is A plus 5D, that is equal to 2 plus 5 into 1 by 2, that is 4 plus 5 by 2, that is 9 by 2. Okay? So the next term A7, this is A plus 6D, and that is equal to A plus 6 into D, 1 by 2, A is 2. This is 2 plus 3 and that is equal to 5. And one more term is needed, A8, that is A plus 7D, and which is equal to A plus 7D, which is equal to 2 plus 7 into 1 by 2, that is 2 plus 7 by 2, that is 11 by 2. So these are the next four terms of the given AP. One more part I should discuss. Let us do the fifth part. Fifth part of the same question.
गिवन एपी इज दिस. Right. So first of all, we have to see the difference between the two consecutive terms. Every pair of consecutive terms, a2 minus a1, 3 plus root 2 minus 3, plus 3 minus 3 get cancelled. This is root 2. Let us find the difference between a3 minus a2. That is 3 plus 2 root 2 minus 3 plus root 2. Followed by bracket. Minus is always followed by bracket. Minus goes inside. This is 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2. You know, when in 9th we did the operations on irrational number, I told you, when under the root the same numbers are there, then the addition different and subtraction is possible. So what is 2 root 2 minus 1 root 2? This is root 2. Right? So let us find a4 minus a3. A4 minus a3 is equal to 3 plus 3 root 2 minus followed by bracket 3 plus 2 root 2. So yeah, when you will subtract it, these get cancelled and this is again comes out to be root 2. So again, for the given list of terms, if you find the difference between the two consecutive terms, it remains the same. So what you will conclude that the given list of numbers, it forms an AP. Given list of numbers hamare paas AP form karta hai. And moreover, we have to list out four more terms. So let us list four more terms. Common difference is root 2. Remember, the difference between two consecutive terms is root 2. That means common difference is root 2. So I'm going to find a5. This is a plus 4d. And that is 3 plus 4 into root 2. That is 3 plus 4 root 2. Right? Similarly, you can find a6, a plus 5d. That is 3 plus 5 into root 2. That is 3 plus 5 root 2. You can find a7, that is a plus 6d, and that is equal to 3 plus 6 root 2, 6 into root 2, 3 plus 6 root 2, and so on. A8, 8th term, you can find a plus 7d, 3 plus 7 into root 2, and that is equal to 3 plus 7 root 2. So this is the way to find the next terms. Rest of the parts you will do yourself. Let us do one more part. Let me do its 13th part. 13th part करवा देती हूँ एक और. Then we'll start with the next concept. 13th part is root 3, root 6, root 9, and root 12, and so on. This is a list of terms which is to be detected for forming arithmetic progression or node. So first of all, a2 minus a1, root 6 minus root 3. Now you see, if I say this root 6 minus root 3, we can't subtract them. Hum inko subtract nahin kar sakte, right? Kyunki agar main isko break bhi karu, it will become root 3 into root 2, kuch bhi bahar nahin aane wala. So it will remain as it is. Let me find a3 minus a2, that is root 9 minus root 6, that is 3 minus root 6. Again, can't be subtracted. Let us find a4 minus a3. A4 minus A3, that is root 12 minus root 9. इसको आप ब्रेक कर सकते हो, जिसको ब्रेक कर सकते हो इसको ब्रेक करके दिखाओगे. 4 into 3 minus 3, 9 का root 3, 4 का square 2, 2 root 3 minus 3, you can't subtract it. So every time when you are subtracting two consecutive terms, the difference is not the same. So you will write, as here difference between two consecutive terms is not the same, therefore, given list of numbers is not forming an AP. Okay? So this is the first exercise. जिसको कि आप हम आप कह सकते हैं, this is a warm up exercise for AP. जिसमें आपने सिर्फ first term और common difference की application करनी सीखी और कैसे common difference find करते हैं with the help of first term, we learn this. So let us start with the next concept in which we learn about nth term and its application to solve the different kind of question. So let us see what is the nth term of an AP. If I am considering the first term of AP to be A and common difference D, so I can write the terms like this: A3, A plus 2D,
A4, A plus 3D.
I'm listing the terms of AP.
So A5, this is A plus 4D. And so you see,
there is a certain pattern. When I'm talking about A1, this is A plus 0 into D. When I'm talking about A2, this is A plus 1D. When I'm talking about A3, this is A plus 2D. When I'm talking about A4, this is A plus 3D. When I'm talking about A5, this is A plus 4D. That means, जो भी यहाँ पे नंबर स्पिक्स में होता है उसको एक कम करके डी के साथ नंबर एसोसिएट हो जाता है राइट सो इन द सेम पैटर्न इफ आई लुक एट एन एट टर्म ए एन दिस इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस अगर स्पिक्स में 5 था 4 हो गया 4 था 3 हो गया 2 था 1 हो गया सॉरी 3 था 2 हो गया 2 था 1 हो गया 1 था डी के साथ 0 हो गया अगर स्पिक्स में एन है तो डी के साथ क्या आएगा उसमें से एक माइनस करके दैट मींस ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इनटू डी दिस इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दिस इज नोन एज एनएट टर्म ऑफ एन एपी मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम वी कॉल इट टू बी जर्नल टर्म आल्सो राइट दिस इज द एनएट टर्म ऑफ एपी एंड हम इसको जर्नल टर्म ऑफ एपी भी कहते हैं ठीक है अब देखना सपोज आई एम राइटिंग एन एपी टू के मल्टीपल्स दे आर फॉर्मिंग एन एपी ये मैंने एपी लिखी राइट सो इस एपी को हम फाइनाइट एपी कहेंगे व्हाई वी विल कॉल इट फाइनाइट एपी बिकॉज इट्स टर्म्स आर फाइनाइट दे कैन बी काउंटेड इफ समवन इज आस्किंग यू हाउ मेनी टर्म्स आर देयर इन दिस एपी यू विल से 5 टर्म्स आर देयर इन एपी बट इफ आई एम राइटिंग दिस एपी लाइक दिस 2 4 6 8 10 सो ऑन देन दिस विल बी कॉल्ड इनफाइनाइट एपी बिकॉज इट्स लास्ट टर्म इज नॉट डिफाइंड इसकी लास्ट टर्म है 10 राइट So there are two kinds of AP, one which is having finite term, another which is having infinite term. Yes, Raghav, roll number 29.
Excuse me, ma'am, हम n को इसके last term कह सकते हैं AP की?
अभी मैं उसी बात में आने लगी हूँ. Just a minute, wait.
When I'm talking about finite AP, जिसमें की number of terms finite हैं, then we can say this nth term is the last term of AP. ठीक है nth term is regarding as last term of AP. But when the terms in the AP is infinite, then we can't say the nth term to be the last term, right? क्योंकि जब जिसकी last term ही नहीं है, उसमें last term को define करना, it is not logical. And which is having the AP which is having last term, उसकी last term को हम nth term ले सकते हैं. Raghav, hope so. I'm clear to you. Raghav, roll number 29. Okay, right. So this is what which is to be applied in the next exercise. So we'll do its application tomorrow, exercise 5.2. Right. Till then, revise this concept. We'll meet tomorrow.